Hello, Ham Radio Now fans. This is Gary, K4AAQ. Yes, many changes. And one of them is that it looks like we're going to be getting Ham Radio Now going again on YouTube and on Facebook. So stay tuned for that. I have moved to South Carolina, and let me show you around a little bit. This is a two-story house, and my domain is the top story. It's actually the top is like a more than a loft, but it's like a half of the house. So we got a gym, and I built myself a little workshop. Never had a great workshop before, so lots of projects have taken place there. I break things more than I fix them, and in a gym. This is the exercise bike and entertainment while I'm working out. And oh, look, massive weight system. Okay, so that's part of it. And now we head into the Ham Shack studio office. And here on these shelves is the, what'll be the Ham Shack. For the moment, it's not doing very much. Some handy talkies and battery chargers. Operating position will be more or less here. The HF station is kind of aspirational because this is a retirement community where I can't really put up antennas outside, and inside it's not looking so good. I'll show you in a second. But the VHF stuff, I can put antennas in the attic. Okay, sure, I'll show you the attic. It's easy to get to. And there's one antenna, easy to see. Tri-band antenna, 6 meters, 2 meters, 70 centimeters. And some more space, although I can't really walk back into there because of the blown insulation. It's real hard to walk and find footing without going through the roof. But if can you see there is an antenna back in there somewhere. I use this pole to hold an antenna and work it through the lumber and back into the depths of the attic. So I might be able to do a little bit more of that. Okay, so go back inside. A little bit messy because I'm in the midst of finishing off the podcast studio, but one more look at the Ham Shack. And then over here, we get to the editing system and the office. There's the big computer I use for editing on Premiere, these days on Premiere Elements, because I can't afford the subscription to Premiere Pro. And a little Ham Shack, little auxiliary Ham Shack. These radios are actually working. They're connected to a couple of antennas, that tri-band antenna, the one that's buried in back in the attic. And so just have some radios while I'm playing here. And then here's what I've been working on now for the past few days and trying to get finished. I got to set up the cameras, the computers, the audio, all that stuff is working. The podcast YouTube studio will be back in operation. So getting close on that. Let's see, I got some shelves over here. You remember the roaming gnome, Arvin. Had to find a place for them. I got another antenna hanging from a vent. When you can't put antennas outside, you gotta figure out what to do with them. And you may wonder why there's a green shirt upside down on this chair. Well, there's also a green screen. Yeah, I'm going to get really fancy with green technology. It works pretty well on Zoom, and we'll see how well it works on the Wirecast, but I can drop that down and have a whatever background I want appear instead of green, you know, like the TV weatherman do. So that's what's coming, and I'm not sure how quickly our first show is going to come out, but hopefully pretty quick. Meanwhile, I did have time to squeeze in a Hamfest, so I thought maybe you'd like to take a look at that. And we'll be back on Ham Radio Now, David and I, as soon as we can. Over and out for now, but here, watch the Hamfest. This is the Cabarrus Arena, home of the Charlotte Hamfest, Charlotte, North Carolina. It is Saturday, March 12th, 2022. The Hamfest actually opens on Friday. It's something they started a few years ago. There used to be a Saturday-Sunday Hamfest, and Sunday was pretty dead. So they thought, well, maybe Friday would do better. It does a little better, but the crowd is a whole lot bigger on Saturday. They also used to be in this expo center just down the road from downtown Charlotte. That space became unavailable, and they moved to the best place they could find, but it was pretty far out of town. That's the Cabarrus Arena. It's about 21 miles away. That's not that far, but it kind of looks like it. The Hamfest is actually in these two buildings here. It is a really nice facility. One of those buildings is set up for commercial exhibitors. Back in the day, early 2000s and before, large regional hamfests like Charlotte featured booths from all the major manufacturers: Yaesu, Kenwood, ICOM, Flex, Elecraft, Tentec, MFJ, and a slew of smaller manufacturers. They also had large distributors like HRO and the late great Amateur Electronics Supply, bringing large inventories and selling all those radios and accessories. But Charlotte is no longer the large regional hamfest that it once was. It took the same hit in attendance that most hamfests did in the early 2000s, and it's been struggling its way back ever since. Meanwhile, the big manufacturers and the big ham stores have concentrated on the few mega hamfests that have rebounded from the slump or never really felt it. Hamfests like Dayton, Orlando, and Huntsville. And hamfests like Charlotte are going back to being big flea markets and social events. Local ARL guys and some local clubs set up booths.
Okay, now it's time to wave, because it's video.
The Mecklenburg County Club, they're the Hamfest sponsor, they set up this testing table where you could check out that flea market treasure. The other building was an indoor flea market, where they sold out all their indoor flea market tables. They did offer outdoor tailgating spaces, but March weather in Charlotte is unpredictable. You can have a nice early spring day, or you can have a foot of snow. Today was a chilly, blustery day with intermittent rain and no fun to hang out outside.
So there's a little bit of diehard flea marketeering going on here.
Yeah, people have no sense.
Inside, though, traffic was good. With most hamfests canceled last year, and with the pandemic still on many people's minds, if not necessarily on their faces in the form of masks, everybody wondered whether hamfests would come roaring back with lots of pent-up demand, or if COVID struck a fatal blow. The answer seems to be somewhere in the middle. We're just kind of going back to normal. Reporting from 23 miles outside of downtown Charlotte, I'm Gary Pierce, K4AAQ.
It's taking me back to my novice station.
Well, you gotta take them back with you. It's the key here.
If I had room for them, I would still have the old ones.